Hej, kontynuujemy Broken Sworda 5. Znajdujemy się na podwórku przed drzwiami posiadłości Hobbsa. No i się tak zastanawiam, czy próbować dostać się tam niepostrzeżenie, czy może od razu zadzwonić do drzwi, czy zapukać. No cóż, no trudno będzie wejść bez wiedzy Hobbsa, więc po prostu zapukajmy. Boję się, że nas widział Medowskiego. Mam nadzieję, że nie. Widział kogoś, ale może nas nie rozpoznać.
I don't think there's anyone home.
There's a light on upstairs.
There was definitely someone home. I'd pounded that door until my hand hurt. We were going to have to find another way to attract Hobbs's attention.
No dobra, czyli mamy zadanie jakoś przyciągnąć uwagę Hobbsa, by zechciał nas wpuścić, ewentualnie wywabić go.
It was Hobbs's mailbox. There was a note hanging out.
I niepostrzeżenie się zakraść do środka.
For a second, I debated the morality of mail snooping. It was a short debate, and I won.
Tak, czyli George wygrał wewnętrzną walkę z własnym sumieniem.
I decided to open the letter. Dear Mr. Hobbs, due to previous incidents, we are writing to inform you that we will no longer be sending models to your address. It went on to discuss Hobbs's temper and other alleged infractions, some of which still carry the death sentence in certain less sophisticated cultures. Interesting. This could come in useful.
Chyba wolę nie wiedzieć, co on robił z tymi modelkami, skoro to coś w niektórych krajach jest karane śmiercią.
Not a sound. The horn wasn't working.
A szkoda, bo na pewno klakson by nam pomógł dostać się do środka. A swoją drogą w samochód w fajnym stanie.
I decided to leave the handbrake alone.
Co tu jeszcze mamy? Jest stacyjka, ale nie mamy klucza.
I'd need the keys to start the engine. I had no reason nor any desire to steal Hobbs's van.
Ale coś tu jeszcze może być. O, jest whisky.
Slasha.
Jeśli jest to pełna butelka, to się na pewno przyda. Alkohole w grach się przydają zdecydowanie w przygodówkach. No dobra, udało się otworzyć maskę, więc jest jakiś sukces. Zobaczymy, co jest ciekawego tam w środku.
The engine was held together by rust and dirt. Everything was covered in a sticky film of dirty black oil. Half the wiring wasn't connected to anything. It was clear why the horn hadn't made a noise. Neither hornpipe was connected to either the battery or the cab. A bundle of wires came into the engine bay from the dashboard. Many of the wires seemed to lead nowhere.
Czyli straszny bałagan. Tutaj brakuje kabli.
It was one of two horns in the van. It didn't seem to be connected to anything else under the hood. Two wires hung loose from it.
No właśnie, trzeba by to wszystko jakoś popodłączać, ale jak? Tu jest blok silnika.
It was the van's engine. I didn't really have any reason to sabotage.
Już i tak wygląda na wystarczająco uszkodzony. Akumulator, bateria i znów drugi klakson.
It was one of two horns in the van. It didn't seem to be connected to anything else under the hood. Two wires hung loose from it. It was the van battery. I needed to hook this up to the horn somehow. A bundle of short, severed wires was connected to the battery. None of the wires were connected to anything.
No dobra, tutaj nic nie zdziałamy. Przydałoby się znaleźć jakieś kable, żeby je podłączać, żeby spróbować chociaż jakąś prowizorkę tutaj zrobić. Co my tu mamy ciekawego oprócz Niko? Chyba Niko jest w tej lokacji najciekawsza. Poza tym śmieci, samochód, który nie działa. Kontener i łańcuch.
I wouldn't have been able to break the chain or the padlock.
Chociaż tak na dobrą sprawę, Niko oraz George niemal w każdej lokacji są najciekawszymi postaciami. Co zrobić z łańcuchem? Może go jakoś przeciąć, ale po co? Żeby narobić hałasu? Nie wiem. Spróbujmy wypuścić Trevora na łańcuch.
There was a slight chill in the air. It would have been cruel to let Trevor out in this weather.
I tutaj widać wielkie przywiązanie George'a do Trevora. Musiałbym mu najpierw jakiś kubraczek chyba uszyć czy nałożyć, żeby móc w ogóle wypuścić na taki mróz Trevora. To się nazywa empatia.
The large dumpster was full of garbage. Piles of junk, mostly boxes of old paints and scraps of picture frames. Mixed in were wires, cardboard and some dubious-looking old clothes.
A, no to są przewody, to dobrze, potrzebujemy przewodów.
George Stobart.
Ah, Monsieur Stobart. I trust you have obeyed my instructions not to leave Paris.
Of course, Inspector.
Good. You clearly know which side your cookie is buttered. Now, I require your presence tomorrow at the murder scene for a reconstruction.
I see.
12 o'clock sharp, Monsieur. Or, as you would say, high noon.
Sure.
Any failure to comply, and I shall have you extraordinarily rendered. Have a nice day now.
And you. That was Nave. We're required back at the gallery tomorrow for a crime scene reconstruction.
Let me guess. Non-attendance is a criminal offense?
You got it.
Oczywiście, że nie opuszczałem Paryża, a tak w ogóle to dzwonię z Londynu. Właściwie odbieram z Londynu. A, nawet się na pewno nie zorientuję. No dobrze, miały być tutaj przewody, więc no poszukajmy, czy rzeczywiście są.
I had found just what I needed. Two lengths of wire.
Dwa, czy dwa nam wystarczą? Zaraz to sprawdzimy.
Engine bay was a mess.
No wiemy, wiemy.
I connected the wires from the cab to the horn.
No dobra. Widać, że długi przewód. Nawet tak długiego nie potrzebujemy w tym miejscu.
I used the wire to join the battery to the horn.
Tutaj to samo, ale jeszcze musimy od jednego klaksonu do drugiego poprowadzić przewód. Czy to jest możliwe? Najpierw sprawdźmy. Tak, więc potrzebne są nam trzy kawałki. Tutaj widać, że jest akurat przewód dobrej długości, natomiast te dwa pozostałe są... Jest dużo, dużo rezerwy. Także może spróbujmy cążkami przeciąć ten długi przewód na pół.
I snipped the wire in half. I connected the wires from the cab to the horn. The wire was just long enough to connect the battery to the horn. Everything was wired up. The horn had power.
Dokładnie, wszystko sięga. Jest połączenie między wszystkimi elementami, które powinniśmy połączyć, więc być może klakson zadziała.
I figured that should get Hobbs's attention.
All right, hold your blooming horses. What are you up to with my van?
Hello there. We fixed your horn.
So I hear. Now what are you doing in my yard?
No tutaj trzeba jakoś go zainteresować, bo jeśli poprowadzimy rozmowę w nie taki sposób, w jaki powinniśmy, to on nie wykaże zainteresowania i wróci tam. Do swojego przybytku, więc pokażmy mu list z agencji modelek. W zasadzie powiedzmy o nim.
Afternoon, Mr. Hobbs. We're from the model agency. About blooming time. I'm on a deadline. You better come up.
About time you two showed up.
Hello, Mr. Hobbs. I was just wondering if...
Can it, Goldilocks? I don't have time for chit-chat. Just get undressed behind that screen.
Undressed?
That was the deal. An extra 20 quid, because I need you with your kit off.
The studio was freezing.
And as for you, darling, no need to get undressed. I've got a vivid imagination, so I'll just use that. Either way, just go sit over there on that rug and give me your best Belle Epoque floozy.
No, proszę, proszę.
That's perfect. Just hold it there.
Nico made for a good distraction. I just needed to figure out how to get a look inside that portfolio.
Czyli według Hobbsa Nico ma strój rasowej kurtyzany i może w tej chwili pozować, przypominając ją. Natomiast George musi się rozebrać. Nie wiem, czy każdym facetom się każe rozbierać, czy to jakieś upodobania jego są w tym kierunku nakreślone, czy po prostu to jest jedynie związane ze sztuką, z tym, co chce przekazać poprzez swoje obrazy. No nie wiem, nie będę się nad tym zastanawiał. Tutaj widać, że ma trochę whisky w szklance. Rozejrzyjmy się może, a może spróbujemy z nim porozmawiać, albo najpierw z Nico.
Hey Nico, got any ideas?
We need to take a look inside that folder.
Oi, you two. Less of the gabbing. I've got work to do.
Excuse me, Mr. Hobbs.
Oh, what do you want? You're supposed to be sprawled naked on that rug with the family jewels out.
Yeah, well, about that. Could I just ask you a couple of questions first?
Blow me. A model who's shy and chatty. It must be my birthday.
No nie wiem, może George powinien brać te dodatkowe 20 funtów i słuchać poleceń, ale nie.
Showing that to Hobbs was not a good idea. It's a little musty in here. Do you mind if I spray some of this around?
Brett! Good lord, man! Put it away! It'll strip the paint off my canvas!
Showing that to Hobbs was not a good idea.
No właśnie, tutaj.
I knew he wouldn't be interested.
Jak można zauważyć, mniej więcej od tej lokacji twórcy pomyśleli, że jednak nie będą tak eksploatować pytania wszystkich o przedmioty. I o coraz mniej przedmiotów z ekwipunku można efektywnie pytać, to znaczy słysząc jakieś indywidualne komentarze. Coraz częściej pojawiają się teksty, że nie byłby zainteresowany, że nie ma sensu pytać.
Cookie, Mr. Hobbs?
No, don't mind if I do. Rich tea. No bourbons?
Afraid not.
Jammy Dodgers?
Sorry.
Stroopwafel?
No, it's just the way I walk. Mr. Hobbs, meet Trevor.
Who's Trevor?
My cockroach. Take a look.
Difficult childhood, eh? Well, don't take it out on me.
Showing that to Hobbs was not a good idea.
No właśnie. No dobra, ale alkohol, pokazywanie alkoholu na pewno ma sens. List z agencji modelek. Nie wiem, czy George będzie zainteresowany pokazywaniem go Hobbsowi.
I have a letter for you, Mr. Hobbs.
From the model agency. Bane in my life, models. Speaking of which, why have you still got your clothes on?
How about a top-up, Mr. Hobbs?
Thanks, but I've already got a glass full.
No dobra, więc może spróbujemy to zrobić, kiedy szklanka się trochę opróżni. Może upicie go uprościłoby nam poszukiwania. Zresztą portfolio jest tutaj, ale jest pod ręką Hobbsa, więc wątpię, by pozwolił nam tutaj zerkać.
Excuse me, Mr. Hobbs.
What now?
I hear you did the restoration of that painting that got stolen recently in Paris?
I might have. It's a fine piece. You can smell the paint in every brushstroke.
Do you know a Russian called Madovsky?
You know Madovsky?
Everyone in the London art scene knows Madovsky.
And everyone in the London art scene who likes their kneecaps knows when to keep their trap shut.
A czyli co? Można się obawiać, że przestrzeli kolana, jeśli się będzie wściubiać nos nie w swoje sprawy. No to kolejny przykład tego, że z Madovskim raczej nie warto żartować, że to jest groźny i bezwzględny przeciwnik.
Excuse me, Mr. Hobbs.
What now?
Tell me more about La Maledixio.
Why all the interest in that picture? We're not at the Slade now, Sonny Jim.
Are you sure you won't talk about Madovsky?
Are you deaf? I already told you to drop the subject.
Yeah, about this naked sprawling...
Oh, what's up? Afraid of the shrinking effects of a cold warehouse?
No, it's just...
First time. A little embarrassed. Well, if it helps, we can all get naked.
No, definitely not.
Well then, what are you waiting for? Let the monkey see the nuts.
We had a saying in the Stobart family. If a job's worth doing, then do it with your pants on.
Ciekawe powiedzenie. Dobrze, że George nie zgodził się na propozycję. Dziwnie by mi się patrzyło na George'a, Nico i tego pana nagich. Także może lepiej, że do tego, mam nadzieję, nie dojdzie.
But I thought you were a restorer, but you're working on this painting from scratch.
Well, yeah. Look, some clients want a painting that they don't own, restored from scratch, if you know what I mean.
No, I don't.
Don't worry, Sunshine. Ignorance is bliss.
Ale to jest akurat prawda. W wielu aspektach życia...
I'll let you get back to your painting.
You're too kind.
Lepiej być ignorantem. Tam są jakieś drzwi. Ale dobra, interesuje nas portfolio. Wątpię, by nasza próba dostania się do niego przeszła niezauważona. Natomiast no, spróbujmy tak. Pro forma.
Hi, what do you think you're doing?
Oh, sorry. I was just gonna take a look at some of your pictures. You're very good.
I know. And that portfolio is private. I'm not paying you to gawp around my studio. Get your blooming clothes off!
Sorry.
A variety of liquor bottles. All empty.
No dobra, czyli... Naszym celem powinno być teraz odwrócenie uwagi Hobbsa, sprawienie, żeby chyba opuścił to swoje miejsce, żebyśmy mogli jednak zerknąć do portfolio.
Hobbs had loosely sketched a young couple and an elderly lady sitting next to an overturned picnic basket. The three characters were naked. Behind them, two men in suits were chatting.
Hey! Leave that dial alone. The heating gobbles up all the power and the circuits can't take it.
Sorry.
I turned the thermostat down again.
No dobrze, drzwi balkonowe, może tam znajdziemy coś, co nas naprowadzi na jakiś pomysł, co tu w ogóle zrobić.
Oh, you! Get down from there, it's private.
Oh, sorry.
Niestety schody skrzypią, więc tak naprawdę nasze pole manewru widać jest bardzo ograniczone. Odtwarzacz, nim zajmiemy się później, bo tutaj negliż.
I didn't want to play around with the negligé. Those days are long gone. But I wondered who it did belong to.
No to sprawdźmy, zajrzymy za parawan.
my, my. If it isn't George Stobart.
Lady Pyrmont. Oh, my. You're...
naked? Of course. As an artist's muse, one often finds oneself en pelotas. Now, George, don't be shy. Come here and give me a big hug.
That day was the day the nightmares had begun. Trapped, smothered, choking on lavender.
George, darling, pass me my robe. It's terribly cold in here.
Oi, what are you doing with a blooming robe on? God help me, but you're supposed to be naked.
I've got a deadline to meet.
Well, you won't be meeting any deadlines with manners like that. And besides, it's freezing in here.
Lady Pyrmont.
Lady Pyrmont and I had met before. She was larger than life, in every way.
Dokładnie. Co ciekawe, Lady Pyrmont była bohaterką dwóch gier studia Revolution Software. W Beneath a Steel Sky miała swoją zabawną rolę. Również ciekawą rolę miała w pierwszym Broken Swordzie. No i tutaj znienacka pojawiła się także w Broken Sword 5. Co ciekawe, tak mi się wydaje, że Lady Pyrmont przemawia tutaj głosem znanym nam z gry The Raven, gdzie osoba z takim głosem wcielała się w alter ego Agaty Christie. Tak. Zdecydowanie. To był chyba ten sam głos. No to oczywiście wymaga weryfikacji, ale tak mi się wydaje. Spróbujmy teraz z nią porozmawiać.
Lady Pyrmont.
Oh, George, be a darling and sort the heating out in here.
I'll see what I can do.
Czyli zanim porozmawiamy konkretniej z panią Pyrmont, to musimy włączyć tutaj ogrzewanie, aczkolwiek Hobbs się na to nie zgodzi, więc no jesteśmy rozdarci między młotem a kowadłem. Natomiast to, że pojawiła się kolejna osoba znana z jedynki, no to jeszcze jeden dowód na to, że twórcy jednak postanowili tym razem tak bardzo jak to tylko możliwe wrócić do korzeni. Trochę może zagrać na sentymencie osób, którym pierwsze odsłony serii tak bardzo się podobały.
Hey! I've told you, don't mess with that thermostat.
Sorry, but Lady Pyrmont is cold. I thought...
Look, pal, I know it's brass monkeys in here, but the wiring in this building is ancient, and the fuse box won't take it. Her Majesty will just have to get used to chapel hat pegs.
Lady Pyrmont, Mr. Hobbs won't let me turn up the heating.
Well, we'll soon see about that.
Oh, crumbs.
If you do not adjust the heating, I shall refuse to cooperate.
Lady Pyrmont, it's the circuits. They won't take the strain. You know what old buildings are like.
In which case, I see no reason for this session to continue.
Whoa, Lady Pyrmont, let's not be too hasty. I'm sure I can accommodate your needs.
Good. Perhaps you can start by letting George here turn up the heating.
Oh, go ahead then, but be careful. The power in here is temperamental.
Po pierwsze,
I turned the thermostat up as far as it would go.
No, czyli bardzo ostrożnie. Po pierwsze, jakoś nie wyobrażałem sobie za bardzo dotychczas.
I wondered if the suspicious wiring could be used to my advantage.
Do mojej pierwszej rozgrywki w Broken Sword 5, Lady Pyrmont w roli modelki. A raczej wydawało mi się, że jej duma by nie pozwoliła na takie zajęcie, by pozować nago jakiemuś malarzowi, chociaż może to ze względu na jej jednak próżność, może chciała być taką damą podziwianą, no nie wiem, trudno mi wniknąć w meandry jej psychiki, w to, o czym marzy w życiu, ale wydawała mi się raczej taką zabawną, arystokratyczną osobowością, która może i ma przerost ego, ale przy tym nie imałaby się takich zajęć, które uważałaby za delikatnie poniżające. To pewnie nie jest poniżające zajęcie, no ale mimo wszystko jakoś pani Pierrot mi do tego dotychczas nie pasowała. Teraz już jest trochę głośniej, ale ciągle myślę, że wchodzenie po schodach nie pozostałoby nieusłyszane, także trzeba jeszcze zadziałać dodatkowo.
Wow, an old Boss and Wang stereo. I hadn't seen one of those for years. Hobbs seemed to have a thing for 70s psychedelic jams. The record had stopped. It was Jasmine Breeze by the Hairy Lobsters.
No to trzeba to uruchomić. Czy to nie jest ten sam utwór, co u Biżu?
Oi, Yank! I can hear you on those stairs again. Get down!
Sorry. If I was gonna take a look up there, I'd have to do something about those squeaky stairs.
Hmm. To dziwne. Bo włączyliśmy muzykę. Termostat też chodzi. Może spróbujmy jeszcze raz. Teraz pojawił się wokal? Nie.
Oi, Yank! I can hear you on those stairs again. Get down!
Sorry. If I was gonna take a look up there, I'd have to do something about those squeaky stairs.
Hmm, dobra, porozmawiamy sobie z panią Pierrot najpierw.
A word if I may, Lady Pierrot. For you, George, I'm all ears. How can I help?
What do you think of this, Lady Pierrot?
Not much, Georgie, not much.
No i tutaj niestety na większość naszych pytań odnośnie do przedmiotów Lady Pierrot po prostu nie będzie odpowiadać. Nawet nie zareaguje na Trevora. To jest smutne dla mnie bardzo. No tutaj już autorzy uznali, że chyba przerosłoby ich to wszystko.
Would you like a sniff of this?
I'd rather not. Gives me 70s flashbacks.
Could I tempt you with a cookie, Lady Pierrot?
You could tempt me with many things, George. But a half-eaten rich tea is not one of them.
How about a shot of this, Lady Pierrot?
Oh, no, dear. I don't touch the stuff. Reminds me of husband number 5. Or was it 6? Terrible bore, anyway. I'm strictly a gin girl. Ice and a slice and a whiff of tonic.
Zdaje się, że to są jedyne przedmioty, które Lady Pierrot jakoś komentuje.
How did you come to be working with Mr. Hobbs?
Wheresoever a bohemian needs a helping hand, George, mine is always at the ready. And what better way to help than to expose one's flesh to the sensuous brushstrokes of such a talent?
Do you know anything about a stolen painting called La Maledixia?
Oh, oh, is this another of your adventures, George? How delicious. My heart's a tremor, George. Do you think Wilf is mixed up with this?
Maybe, but I need you to act normally until we're sure.
Mum's the word, Georgie.
Can you keep a secret, Lady Pierrot?
I am the very soul of discretion, as you know.
You see that portfolio by Hobbs's table? We need to take a peek inside.
Be still, my beating heart. Just give me the nod and I'm putty in your hands.
So what have you been up to since our last encounter, Lady Pierrot?
Charity work, dear boy.
Oh, any particular kind?
Young men, George. So many have lost their way. I try to guide them best I can.
That's all for now.
No dobra, jeszcze jedną rzecz zrobimy. Spróbujmy nalać whisky do szklanki Hobbsa. bo widzę, że ma pustą szklankę.
How about a top up, Mr. Hobbs?
Don't mind if I do.
Spróbuję wejść na te schody. Może w ten sposób, po prostu wchodząc na schody, a nie zwracając uwagę od razu na drzwi. Nie.
Oi, Yank! I can hear you on those stairs again. Get down!
Najwyraźniej czegoś nie zrobiłem.
If I was gonna take a look up there, I'd have to do something about those squeaky stairs. Didn't need to sit. It was time for action. I wasn't gonna mess around with that wiring.
W takim razie sprawdźmy jeszcze raz odtwarzacz. Być może trzeba tutaj dać głośniej po prostu.
I turned the volume up a few notches.
Więc jednak, no to teraz na pewno już nawet nie zauważy, że schody skrzypią.
You get down from there. You'll trip the power in the whole building if you're not careful.
Blowing the power would certainly have distracted Hobbs, but the elevator alone wasn't going to trip the whole system.
Ale jeśli słusznych rozmiarów pani Pirmont, oczywiście nie mówię, że jest jakaś masywna czy potężnie zbudowana, ale jednak swoje waży. Jeśli stanie tutaj na windzie i jeśli tę windę przywołamy na górę, to może być ciekawie. Zaproponujmy jej to może. Ona jest wielką miłośniczką detektywistycznych historii.
For you, George. I know the others. How can I help?
Anything else you can tell me about Mr. Hobbs?
My lips are bound by discretion, sweet boy.
It was clear that Lady We're still trying to figure out a way to distract Hobbs and take a look in that portfolio. Lady Pyrmont wasn't going to tell me anything else. Lady Pyrmont, we need your help.
How thrilling! What do you need? Subterfuge? Pleasure to know?
Actually, I just need you to step on that lift behind you.
Oh, but of course.
Chłopina by mógł sobie trochę łyknąć. Nalaliśmy mu alkoholu, whisky, a on nic nie rusza. Hobbs się zdenerwował.
There we go. Now, back to work.
I decided to wait until Hobbs was painting again. That would annoy him.
Aha. Teraz trochę łyknął sobie, bo to go zestresowało. Widać, jak się kołysze, także jest już trochę wcięty. Może tam dłużej zabawi, może spadnie z taboretu. I tutaj wam zdradzę, że gdybyśmy mu nie wlewali whisky do szklanki, gdyby nie był lekko pod wpływem, to szybko by załatwił sprawę i nie zdążylibyśmy zajrzeć do jego portfolio.
It was one of Hobbs' sketches. More of Hobbs' sketches. The model looked familiar.
Hmm. Może podobna do biżu, bo chyba nie do Niko.
Impressionist sketches. Well, it wasn't La Maledizio, but it did appear to be a study for an element of the painting, the Ouroboros. There was something different about the image in the center. I figured the sketch might come in handy, so I took it.
What the heck are you doing with those? They're private papers.
Huh?
Well, that was fun. Just like when you were a private Dick George.
So, you're not models?
No, Mr. Hobbs.
Well, you can't be a copper. You're not stupid enough.
So what the blazes are you doing in my studio?
We're investigating the theft of La Maledizio.
I told you, I just restored it. That's what I do. Restore paintings.
And these sketches?
Studies done during the restoration. Nothing more. I've got nought to do with what happened after that painting left this studio. How was I to know it was going to get Henri killed?
Nie jesteście gliniarzami, bo nie jesteście wystarczająco głupi. Dobry, trafny wniosek. Nie no, oczywiście żartuję sobie. Nie mam takich informacji, nie mam do czynienia raczej z policjantami, więc trudno mi o jakiekolwiek obserwacje, aczkolwiek wniosek bardzo ciekawy.
Hang on a second. How do you know Henri's dead?
Look, he and I went back a long way. The Lézard Bleu was on the rope, so I got the painting into his exhibition. Nothing like this was supposed to happen.
Twardo. Twarde rozmowy zazwyczaj przynoszą więcej korzyści.
But something did happen, Hobbs. Your friend lost his life.
No. I'll help you however I can, but this mess is way above my pay grade. What do you want to know?
Znów nie odpowie na pytania dotyczące przedmiotów.
I just taken the sketch from Hobbs's portfolio. Now wasn't the time to hand it back. How come you needed to make so many sketches of the painting to restore it?
Restoration is not about throwing a load of paint around. It takes research. The Serf is a complicated painting. A lot of subtext. A lot of symbols.
Why would anyone want to steal La Maledizio? It's not exactly a famous painting.
True, but there is something special about it that's hard to describe. There's conviction in every brushstroke. Whoever El Serp was, he had a tale to tell. The symbolism is deeply religious.
No, na to wygląda, skoro ta symbolika niemal przeraziła ojca Simeona. Swoją drogą w tej lokacji zauważyłem kilka literówek w tłumaczeniu, ale to tak na marginesie.
We have reason to believe that Madowski is mixed up in the theft of La Maledizio.
Eh? What would he gain from stealing his own painting?
We have strong evidence that Madowski is not the real owner.
He'll have a hard time proving that. Madowski has a full set of provenances for the painting. It traces its legitimate ownership all the way back to the painter.
Why didn't Madowski mention it?
Because they're not with him. Henri's got them, or had them.
And Henri is dead.
So ask his partner.
Lane?
Lane, yeah, Lane. Look, pal, you're wasting your time looking for conspiracies here. And you're wasting my time if you're not actually going to get naked. Go get the provenance from Lane, and everything will turn out hunky-dory.
But it also puts Marquez's story into question.
Not my problem, darling. Now, both of you, get lost. I've got a painting to finish.
And we have a critic to interrogate.
Someone's lying, but who?
Is it the gangster or the old Spaniard?
The painter or the art critic?
I need to head back for Nave's reconstruction.
What about the evidence from Medovsky's house? Will you give it to Nave?
I think I should. And I can put the squeeze on Lane. Ask him about the provenance.
Good. I've got lunch with Ronnie tomorrow. This story is hurting up, and I want to make sure he keeps me on it.
Akurat Medowskiego prawdomówność bym nie podejrzewał.
Here I was again at the crime scene. Inside the gallery, I could see lots of activity. Now they preparing for the reconstruction, no doubt.
To może być zabawne.
Nico and I had a good idea who the killer was. Now all we had to do was persuade Nave.
Sir, I already tried starting it up. I think it's broken.
Nonsense, Moo. This machine has the power of 10 investigators.
But investigators never fail to start up, sir.
Your pessimism is duly noted, Moo. But have faith. This machine will analyze the scene, compute the data, and deduce everything for us. The location of the second shooter will be a mystery no more. One moment.
A marvel indeed, sir. Though at the moment, it is kaput.
Your pessimism has obviously infected the circuitry, Moo. Let me think for a moment.
If I could just...
Shh! Eh bien, Moo, now try realigning the laser matrix.
Sir, I have no idea what that is. Move over, Moo.
Now, let me see. Oscillating reverberator? Check. Refraction spectrometer? Check. Now... What can I do? Ah, Monsieur Stobacht, it's only you. Glad you could finally make it.
Inspector. I've got some good news and some bad news.
Oh, yes? I shall be the judge of that.
I think I know who the killer is.
Really?
Yep, he's a gardener called Shears living in London.
Fascinating. And the good news?
We don't need to do your reconstruction.
You joke with me, Monsieur Stobacht.
It's not a joke. This guy Shears was working for a Russian ex-mobster. It's all part of a highly complex fraud.
Gardeners, KGB, fraud. You have fantasies, Monsieur. And I have no time for fantasy. Reality is my suitcase, as you Americans say. Now, stand over there and keep out of trouble until the others arrive.
Well, who are we waiting for?
Mademoiselle Collard and Father Simeon. Please, I am very busy. Ah, Moo, a clever choice. But no cigar for you. Try the red.
Mon Dieu!
Chyba im nie wychodzi za dobrze to majstrowanie przy aparaturze.
Lane.
Stobart.
Bez entuzjazmu Lane powiedział Stobart.
What's the deal with that device over there?
It's a farce. They've been trying to get it working for hours.
Looks like something out of a 50s sci-fi movie.
It probably is.
What do you think of Nave?
The man is a buffoon. I have better things to do than wait for these idiots to get their forensic whatnot to work. The only silver lining is that Nave seems more annoyed than I am.
I gather you're the man to ask about the provenance for the painting.
For La Maledixio? Well, you have been busy, haven't you, Stobart?
I'd like to see it.
So speak to Bijou. She took care of the business side of the gallery. The provenance is in the office safe. She has the key.
Lane was a pushover when he had him cornered. Though it looked like Bijou hadn't been completely honest with me after all.
I needed to pay her another visit. What do you think of Moo?
Who?
The policeman with Nave.
I assume he's another idiot.
Why's that?
I believe one can tell a man by the company he keeps.
I'll bear that in mind, Mr. Lane. Okay, thanks.
Surowa ocena, ale yes. Przynajmniej...
Sir, I think we are ready to fire her up.
przeciwieństwie do Naveta, Mu jest przynajmniej sympatyczny. Kolejna demonstracja.
What have you done?
Pardon me, sir, but I believe it was you who said,
"This is no time for blame. You have broken the machine."
Mon Dieu.
Dobra, my mamy się udać do Bijou, tylko czy pozwolą nam teraz wyjść?
Stobart. Monsieur Stobart, you will not leave until this is over. Understood?
But I just need to...
This is a reconstruction. You will remain here until I have concluded my investigations. Do I make myself clear?
Okay, okay, clear. I considered making a run for it, but forcing Mu to chase me would have been cruel. And it would have been silly to risk my investigation. Better to play along with Nave and get the reconstruction over as quickly as possible.
Rekonstrukcja może zleci szybko, ale najpierw trzeba uruchomić tę maszynę, sprawić, by zadziałała. Tak, Nave ma bardzo fajny akcent, ale umiejętności jednak mu brakuje.
Inspector Nave. What seems to be the problem?
Monsieur Stobart, if Paris finest cannot get this very expensive and very complex machine to work, then I doubt if an insurance salesman can.
I'm an insurance assessor, actually.
Oh, I see. Well, la-di-da to you, monsieur.
Oh, yeah? Well, la-di-da to you back.
Whatever. You are neither qualified nor clever enough to operate such an instrument.
Like us.
What was that, Mu?
I said, unlike us, sir.
Have you been a detective long?
Long enough, monsieur?
You've solved a lot of crimes, I guess.
More than you have had hot dinners.
Well, I've had a lot of hot dinners, Inspector.
Oh, yes? How many?
What?
Precisely how many hot dinners have you had, monsieur?
Don't know. Thousands?
You prove my point for me, monsieur. Precision and accuracy are everything.
You truly are a unique and amazing man, Inspector Nave.
Well, I'm glad you are impressed.
I was sure I could get the machine to work if I could just get Nave out of the way.
Czyli trzeba odwrócić jego uwagę. Odwracanie uwagi to jest zajęcie, które ostatnimi czasy dominuje tutaj w Broken Swordzie 5. Ale jeszcze spróbujemy może zagadać do sierżanta Mu.
Excuse me.
Please, monsieur, I'm a little busy.
Nic z tego, dobra. Zobaczmy, gdzie biegnie kabel. A, do gniazdka po prostu. Wyciągnijmy wtyczkę z kontaktu. Niczego nie zauważyli, dalej bawią się urządzeniem.
Inspektor Nave. I know this sounds obvious, but are you sure it's plugged in?
Monsieur Stobart, do you really think I would be so stupid as to not check the fundamentals?
We all make mistakes.
What a ridiculous generalization, monsieur. Look, I can see from here, it's... Ah.
Do you need assistance, sir?
Very funny, Mo.
One moment.
That got rid of him. Now is my chance. I was going to have to figure that out quickly.
Zapewne wszystkie muszą się świecić na zielono. Ach, drugi i czwarty. Pierwszy i piąty. Pierwszy i piąty, właśnie drugi i czwarty. Pierwszy i trzeci. Drugi i czwarty. I czwarty, piąty. Zaraz. Pierwszy i trzeci. Trzeba by to sobie dobrze zapisać wszystko. Nie mam akurat pod ręką nic do pisania. Chociaż mam długopis. To zaraz. Jedynka, piątka. Dwójka, czwórka. Jedynka, trójka. To będzie teraz. Ok. Nie było zbyt trudne.
Time to get the show on the road.
See, Mu? I knew I would get it working.
I'm not sure that you...
Precisely. You knew my superior intellect would win through in the end.
Yes, sir. Sir, I beg your pardon, but I think there is a teeny snag. Go.
Go on.
We have no victim.
Good God, Mu, are you suggesting I kill someone for the sake of this reenactment?
No, sir. Just saying we need a body, sir.
Ah, yes. I see. You'll make a detective yet, Mu. I, of course, foresaw this, and I nominate... you.
Me? Well, I'm not dead.
Have you ever acted, Monsieur Stobart?
Well, I don't like to blow my own trumpet, but I went down a storm playing the lead in Cat on a Felt-Tip Roof last summer.
Hmm. You played the cat?
No.
So, not the lead. Half-truths again, monsieur. Nevertheless, here is your chance to play a real lead role.
But he looks nothing like the victim, sir.
Oh, damn it, Mu. Must you find problems all the time? Let me think of a way to make this work.
Relying on Nave's problem-solving skills could mean a long, long wait. I had to find something to make me more like Henri.
I'll have a look around. Maybe I'll find something.
Yes, you do that. Verisimilitude is the key, Stobart. Ah, you have arrived at last. Please, make yourselves comfortable. We are just making some last-minute adjustments.
Father Simeon, Nico.
Hi, Josh.
Welcome to the asylum.
Let me guess. Nave is overjoyed we've solved the case and he's putting us up for an award.
Not quite. I told him about Shears and Medovsky. He says it's fantasy.
But that's crazy.
Tell me about it.
So what do we do now?
Carry on anyway, and nail Medovsky.
What about Nave?
Ignore him.
And this charade?
The reconstruction? Well, sooner it starts, sooner it's over.
Josh, what on earth is that machine?
It's Nave's baby. Supposedly, it's going to analyze the crime scene and tell us what happened.
But we already know what happened.
Sure we do, but Nave doesn't.
Quiet, please! How can I concentrate with all this racket going on?
Lane was right. Nave was an idiot.
To ciekawe, że teraz analizują sos do pizzy tym swoim urządzeniem, to jedno. Dwa, George ma się wcielić w rolę ciała, ale George przecież był, kiedy tutaj doszło do całego tego zdarzenia, także jeśli ktoś ma grać rolę ciała, to powinna to być osoba, która nie była obecna, bo inaczej swojej roli w tej rekonstrukcji nie odegra. Także ten pomysł ma pełno dziur, no i obnaża brak kompetencji Naveta. No ale dobrze, odcinek trwa już długo, także kończyć rekonstrukcję będziemy w kolejnym odcinku. Na teraz to już wszystko. Dziękuję Wam serdecznie za uwagę. Do usłyszenia. Pa, pa.